Hello there everyone, welcome to this tutorial. We're gonna be doing something different this time. I've been focusing a lot on hair, geometry nodes, stuff like that. But I think we should also include something like this, which is robots, texturing, quickness of 3D modeling. And that is actually what we're gonna be doing now. It's not something incredibly fancy or anything, just a cute little robot, and the idea behind it is that it's just a robot that is scouting the environment after, for example, an apocalypse. So it is rusty, worn down, just roaming around with its scanner on its head, just trying to find new things. All right, so that is what we're going to be making. We're going to be making this from scratch with textures, and there is an amazing feature that I want to show you to get some amazing edge wear. You can see it right here. It's nice and grungy. So we're gonna start this off with part one, which is the modeling and some tips on, well, how to set up something like this, robots, how to quickly set it up, right? So that's what we're gonna be doing. So if you like this video, please remember to leave a like or a comment or subscribe. Any of those will make me incredibly happy, and good luck with the tutorial. Right, so in Blender, you've got your default scene with the cube. Of course, we're gonna delete this guy up, and we're gonna add, let's just build a very quick and simple robot. Let's do some quick editing and some hard surface modeling. All right, so robots, I usually start off with like a little circle whenever I want to create a cylinder. I don't know why I like it better. Just gonna create a little main body shape. I'm not gonna go too much into detail, but it's gonna be fine. And robotic stuff usually has a lot of kind of splits in a mesh, things where lines where things come together, where different hard surfaces come together, so like that. So that's just what I'm gonna be doing a little bit. So by adding a new object, scaling them down a little bit, separating faces as a new object, and then extruding that, making it a little bit bigger like that. So the way I'm doing this is I'm just pressing, for example, I'm selecting a face. Face select mode is 3. Selecting a face, shift D, escape P, and separate by selection. So now this face is a new object, right? So I can then just go into edit mode and then just edit this new object, for example, like that. If we want this to go up, we can do it. Control B to bevel, for example. I'm gonna create a nice and rough bevel like that. Let's say, what is this? Let's say this is going to be part of the head. Actually, this is gonna be the upper body, okay? So then we need a part where the neck of the robot sticks out so it can actually rotate and stuff. So it's gonna be able to rotate its head. So I'm gonna extrude this in a little bit. And just like that. Insert this one more time, extrude it, shift D, escape P, select, easy, select a new object. It is going to be the part where like the neck sticks out, right? So we need a new part where it can actually rotate, if that makes sense. I'm gonna shift D this one more time and extrude this. Now press A, Alt S, and just scale that in a little bit. So I like seeing those little gaps there. In real life, when you have robotic parts, things need to rotate, you want as less friction as possible. Which means that you generally don't want parts to touch unless there is some kind of oil or lubricant in between. So if there is a way where you could, for example, prevent two metal objects to wear each other out, then that is, of course, beneficial. Right, so I'm gonna just move this back a little bit like that. And now I'm just gonna press Shift D, Escape, P, Selection. And let's select it. And let's just extrude it out and press S, so ES, like that. And I'm gonna delete this inner face. Where is it? Can I select it? There it is. I wanna delete that. Let's see what we've got. All right, so I gotta delete the whole thing, actually. There we go. So we only have this edge right there. I'm gonna scale it up a little bit in edit mode. Like that. And I'm just gonna extrude it down a little bit, like so. This is going to be the start of the head. So this is where it would rotate around this inner part, for example. Excuse me. Alright, so that's looking beautiful. If you want your head to be able to turn, for example, up and down, you need some kind of a hinge, or you could also have a sphere, like a hip joint, where it could rotate around. So, for example, we could just add a sphere. If we do it like this, we extrude this, scale this out, extrude this up, insert it, extrude it down, and scale this down a little bit as well. We could insert this now and extrude it. Shift D, Escape P, selection. And select that inner part, extrude it up a little bit, like that. And this is where I want a sphere to be on. Like, this is going to be a little bit of a hip joint idea. So I'm going to press Shift S curse to select it. Shift A, mesh with sphere, like that. So this is going to connect, be connected to that part right there. And we could even do that with a boolean. Or an easier way to do it is just to delete this, the cylinder. Move this up a little bit, select the lower parts, like that, and this. And then just extrude that at Z0. Make that scale on the Z axis 0. So we can now just move this down back into that little hole there, like this. And now we've got our own hip joint. Wow. So this is something. Oh, this is something that your head object will actually be able to move around. Right? So it could move up, down, just like your shoulder. Well, shoulder is not really a good example. But more of like your hip, right? It rotates in a socket. So if you now create a socket, for example, by duplicating this upper part right there and Shift D, Escape P, selection, we now have this upper part. I'm going to set the origin to the geometry. Scale this up a little bit. Remember, we want as little friction as possible. Usually in a joint like this, there is going to be some kind of lubricant in between, right? So I'm just going to use this. So now if we set the origin to the sphere, so select the sphere, Shift S curse to select it, and then select this little socket, set origin to 3D cursor. If you rotate this now, it's going to be rotating around your nice little sphere right there. All right, so I'm going to press A, extrude this up a little bit, scale it up a little bit as well, and extrude it again. SZ0, there we go. And then I'm gonna move it down, scale it up a little bit more even, and extrude that up now, like that. Control P, create a small bevel perhaps. Can we? And if we scale this down, this edge, we can for sure create a little bevel there. Beautiful, that is looking great. Right, the head sticks out a little bit much. Fun part now is that we can parent everything to the inner part, this part. So the neck, Control P. Set parent to object. So now when we move this neck down, we actually can create some robot movements, like the neck can stick out. It can get big in. So we can create some movements later on if we want to animate it, right? So that's beautiful. And now we want this can now rotate freely around that little sphere, right? And I usually don't worry about what happens inside of these parts, how they actually rotate around each other. I'm not going to get into that much detail. Usually you can make some kind of a piston, for example, piston motion, where it actually makes sense how this head rotates. But you could also have like a little motor inside of the sphere that drives a part or a chain inside of the head, for example, that makes it turn. All right. So for now, this is a tutorial more about the materials and edge wear. So I'm going to be satisfied with this. I'm gonna shade everything nice and smooth. There we go. So we got a little bit of a robot there. Beautiful. And actually I'm gonna do one more thing, which is just create some more extrusions. So I'm gonna extrude this up a little bit, like that. I don't really like how this was all connected. This is looking better. So now I can rotate it head. Boop, boop, boop. Nice. All right, let's just create a little bit of a way for him to move around. Scale this up a little bit, like that. Let's inset this, extrude it up. And this is by no means like a good robot. This is just something that I'm creating on the spot. So I'm just going to inset this one more time, extrude it, inset it, and extrude it one more time. Shift D, Escape P, selection. So now we have this separate face right there. Select it. And just extrude it down. There we go. So now we've got like a little base that our body could move around on. So I want a little wheel here. And by Making this a separate axis, we can have the whole body rotate around the real wheel while the wheel keeps going forward, for example. Right, so how do we attach a little wheel? It's not that hard. I'm gonna inset this one more time. I want this to be a little bit smaller, so I'm gonna inset this a few times like that and extrude it out. Remember, there's always a nice, it's always looking nice when there are like these little insets. You have some thick shadow that will fall in there later. Something like this. Shift S, cursor to select it. Shift A, mesh plane. I'm not gonna work with a square for once. And seal this in the X-axis like that. Right, now extrude it down like that a little bit. And let's extrude it all in the Z direction. So E, something like this. And I'm gonna add two loop cuts. So Control R and scroll up once. Left click to apply and escape to cancel. S, X, and just scale that to the size a little bit. I want it to be pretty much there, just outside of that cylinder. And let's move those outer parts in, S, X, and just scale that in a little bit. And I'm going to select these two faces and extrude this down like that. And maybe, yeah, this is fine. I'm going to scale this entire object down in the X axis, S, X, like that. All right, so I'm going to press 2 in Edge Select and select this edge. Shift S cursor to select it, Shift A mesh, and let's add a circle. Scale that down, RY90, and scale this down even more. This is going to be the wheel. So I'm going to press G and X, tap F to fill that up and extrude it a little bit, right? Add some thickness to that wheel, and let's scale it up a little bit as well after we set the origin to a geometry. Scale it up, place a little bit more to the middle, just like that. Press tap. Press 3, select the outer two faces, inset them a little bit, like that. Right mouse, bridge faces. So now we have a hole. I'm going to press Shift D, Escape P selection. So this is going to be the axis where the wheel will turn around. Press tab and just fill up those faces, or sorry, those edges by double clicking and pressing F to fill them up, and press S and X and just kill them in the X direction a little bit, like that. Shade it smooth, shade the wheel smooth. And this has to be a little bit more up, so I'm actually going to press S, Shift, X, and scale this all down a little bit, so we have a little bit of a gap. And let's just move these faces down, GZ, like that. So they actually cover the parts where our cylinder will be connected, and make sure that it is, so S, X. Just like that, beautiful. There we go, we've got a robot with a little wheel so it can move around at least. Beautiful, I'm gonna save this real quick as a robot. Now there we go. Now let's worry about the materials because that's what we're here for. We made a very quick robot in about, I'd say less than 10 minutes. So that's fine. It doesn't have hands or anything. We could make something to grab it. I'm not gonna worry about that for now. It's just gonna be a discovery robot, right? So let's just make a little bit of a light on top. Let's actually extrude this in like that, inset it, extrude that up like that. Shift S cursor select this, Shift A. Let's add a little circle, fill that up, extrude that up, and let's bevel the top part, scroll up a few times and make sure that it just looks fucked up, because now you can go to bevel and just clamp that overlap to make it look normal again. Right, so now just press A, 1, M, and merge by distance. Usually when you do a bevel like this, there will be some kind of overlap. So make sure to remove those dibbles. Shade this smooth. And I'm just going to add a little edge loop there. Press 3, select this loop, Shift D, Escape, P selection. And I'm just going to select that and press tab on that one. E, Alt, S to scale that up a little bit. Alright, so this is going to be the ring around. This is going to be some kind of scanner, some kind of a light at least. I want this to be, the idea that just popped into mind, so I want this to be a discovery robot that can drive around and just scan the environment like Google does as well to make 3D street view images. Alright, you just have something that is going to scout the areas, and it's going to be a little robot. Right, so let's make some materials. So swipe this window to the left like I just did right there in the top left. And let's set that to Shader Editor. Let's go to the render tab, set that to cycles, and set the device to GPU. Because GPU rendering is better. Well, if you have a good GPU, that is. Alright, so let's see what this looks like. I'm going to delete this little light. And I'm going to go to my environment settings and set that to an environment texture. Open an HDR. I have some pictures of my eyeball. Don't ask me why. I was about to make some eyes in Blender with my own eye. So that's always fun to incorporate some of your own features into 3D. All right, so that's why that was there. Don't worry about it. So let's find a suitable HDRI for our little robot. And I want this to be like in a workplace, right? Perhaps, I'm not sure. So this one looks nice. It is called Peppermint Power Plant. And you can download these HDRIs for free on polyhaven.com. So open that up. And now we have some nice lighting is what I mean. And we can now see that we've got some nice lights. So I'm going to shade this smooth. The reason why our background is completely brown is because we are in front view. If we move it around a little bit, you can see that we actually have a workshop, a power plant around our character. Right, that's the end of part one. We did the modeling, and next part we're going to do the texturing of the metal. All right, that's going to be fun. All right, thank you for watching. If you like this part, please like, comment, subscribe. I'd love any one of those. I'll hope to see you in the next one, because it's going to get fun. All right, thank you so much. Bye.